I'm Hugo Calderano. I'm a table tennis player. Yeah, I think now people start to know me in table tennis. I won already some good matches in the World Tour and some ITTF events. So of course everybody knows me and they study my game. But I think it's natural and I study their game also. I just want to be a good player and I have to deal with it. It's not a big problem for me. No, I don't think I feel the pressure. I just like to use it on my favor. I like to have this pressure and I don't feel it as a bad thing. I like this kind of pressure. Yeah, of course. I love my fans and I'm very thankful for the support they give me. And yeah, I know that I need to be careful with what I say, but I can use it also to develop table tennis in Latin America and in Brazil. And I'm really happy that many people enjoy table tennis and enjoy following me. I think it was when I was playing against Tang Peng in the Olympic Games and I heard the crowd singing that I'm better than Neymar. So I was playing very focused, but I could understand that. And it was a boost of confidence. And at that moment, I realized that I could become someone special in Brazil, in the sports. Yeah, I really love Brazil. Of course, it's my country. I like the people. I like the country in general. There are many different things. The culture is very big. So I'm always happy to represent Brazil in international tournaments. In table tennis, I don't really have an idol because I see everyone as an opponent that I have to beat. So of course I respect many good players, but if I have to choose one idol, it would be Federer from tennis because of his personality in and off the court. He's very calm and very respectful of the others, and I really like him, I like his game. I think it's my mental part. I can manage to be calm and very hot at the same time, and I think that's very important for table tennis. Yeah, I think the calendar is a very important part for a high-level athlete. We plan it very well because it can lead to injuries if I play too many tournaments or too many games in the league also. And I think we need to plan it well. And for the tournaments and the games, we like to prepare just, we don't really study together many players. Just we share some ideas when we know I'm going to play with someone else. Yeah, my family plays a very important role in my career. Since the beginning, they always supported me. I had to move away from my home when I was 14. And my grandfather, he moved with me to another city in Brazil. So that showed how much support they were willing to give me. And also, of course, my father, my mother, even my sister, they give me so much support. It's not easy living away from them, but I know they will always be there supporting me and cheering for me. I used to play volleyball until I was 13, and also I competed in track and field, in long jump, and I was the champion in Rio for long jump in my city, under 12 years old. And I was in the city team for volleyball also. So I had to choose to stop these two sports to stay only on table tennis. Yeah, I think I made the right choice. And I'm, of course, I love table tennis and I'm happy with this decision. Yeah, of course, it's a very tough life being a high-level athlete. But there's not one day that I regret making this choice. I would always choose the sport and this life of commitment and sacrifice. I like to give my best and give my all every day in practice and in the competitions. If you are starting table tennis or any other sport, I would tell you to never stop believing, to chase your dreams and to believe everything is possible with a lot of work, because talent is only one part of success, and you have to practice and train a lot to be successful.